A child who has been given birth today cannot automatically walk overnight. It is a journey that involves steps and steps process. Let's have confidence that President Bola Ahmed Tinubu and his team, the Vice President, the Secretary of the Government of the Federation, the Service Chief, will not disappoint us. Let's have confidence in them that we are going to get there. It will not be now, but we are sure that we're going to get there. Now, America has celebrated over 200 years of their independence. We will not become America overnight until we get to that stage or the processes that involve in passing through for it to become a greater country. On behalf of the rising of United Nigerian, I want to assure the country that we are solely behind the country, we are solely behind the president and his leadership, that we are ever ready to promote, to protect, and project the country interest of the renewed world. To appreciate and thank God for the journey so far. It has not been easy, but we thank God that we are where we are, and we are going to we are headed to the promised land under the leadership of President Bola Ahmed Tinubu, Commander-in-Chief of Nigerian Armed Forces. Let me use this singular opportunity to appreciate everyone who have faith in the country, who have hope in Nigeria, that the renewed hope is going to give us the desired result. Let me appreciate
all of you, the boys. Great Nigerian people. It is a big joy that we, the leadership of the Rise Up for United Nigeria, the umbrella body representing the over 100 million young and middle-aged citizens of Nigeria, have stood here or compared here on the ground of Nigeria's unity founding to commemorate Nigeria's 63rd independence and independence. Great Nigerian youth, we will not stay in ignorance of the fact that we are faced with challenges as a country. We are faced with challenges of diverse sorts. But what is more heartwarming is the fact that we are also greeted at the doors of opportunity for a greater and a better nation to emerge, to take a brighter place in the front lines in the community of nations. Also, we should note that Nigeria has come to our present point, a point where we have been pressed with challenges to the extent that nature and divinity has gifted us with the most courageous, most determined, and most focused president in the person of President Bola Ahmed Tinubu. Great Nigerian youth, it should be known that all countries that have emerged to become great countries have been faced by challenges in times past. The essence of our gathering here, bringing thousands of youth leaders from across the nooks and crannies of our country, is to let the world know, and the enemies of our country to know, that those who mean evil for our country will no longer have anywhere or any place to hide. We are not unaware of the fact that the extremist elements, enemies of our country, those who want to incite anarchy, and they have been doing all that they can, tooth and nail, to derail the country, to distract the government, and to sow seeds of discord in the hearts and minds of the youth of our country. We have come here as a youth on this solemn day of our independence and liberty to reiterate the dreams of our founding fathers that yes, there was a Nigeria and there still is a Nigeria and there still will be a greater Nigeria. Nothing can suffer. We are at the time where Nigeria is emerging to become a pride in the front line in the committee of nations. Youth of our country, the essence of our gathering here is to urge us that at this gate of opportunity, we must not despair or be overwhelmed by the challenges that face us. Already, we can see that we have a firm government, a government that has a senior administrator in the presence of the NGF, we have a new breed of service chiefs who are determined as an armed forces to bring down every seed of disunity, to bring down every ounce, every element of terrorism, to bring down insurgency and to combat insecurity. Today, we are here to sound a deep warning to the enemies of our country that there is no space in the hearts and the minds of the Nigerian youth. The only space we have is to rise up with renewed hope. The only space we have is to forge along with the vision and the dream of our founding father, with the vision of Mr. President, that the new Nigeria can and shall indeed be better. I urge us all, youth of our country, to know on this solemn day of our independence that this is a time where Nigeria is getting our true independence, where Nigeria is saying no to neo-colonialism, where Nigeria is rising to the front line to take our pride of place, where our president can stand shoulder to shoulder with presidents of world economies, can speak to the president of France, can speak to the United Nations, can speak and let the world know that we are not begging. I want to assure you all, Nigerian youth, that a new era is here, an era where there is a firm partnership between the executive and the legislature, an era where our security agencies, our armed forces, are not resting on their own, but are in the field, night and day, under the sun and in the rain. And that is why, as young citizens of our country, we have also come symbolically to stand under this scorching sun in solidarity with our soldiers, with our Navy, with the Nigerian Army, with the Chief of the Army Staff, with the Chief of the Naval Staff, with the Chief of the Defense Staff, with the Chief of the Air Staff. That yes, across the nooks and crannies of our country, we will not give any room for terrorism. We will not give any room for insurgency. We will not give any room for insecurity. Finally, before we leave this solemn ground, I want to assure everybody that the Department of State Security particularly has been doing a whole lot in gathering security intelligence to ensure that we will not only be dealing with crimes as they occur, but even before they occur, the Department of State Services is giving the relevant security agencies all the intelligence that is needed to nip these crimes in the bud. We are going back to our farms. We are going back to our industries. We are going back to our offices. We are going back to the hinterland. We are going back to the rural areas where our wealth is. We are going back to where the opportunities of Nigeria are. We are taking back our minefields. We are taking back our farmland. We are taking back our industrial field. Nigeria is rising to become that great country that he has always had that potential to be. We are taking back the television producing hub. We are taking back the car producing industry. We shall begin to produce what we consume. We shall begin to drive Made in Nigeria cars. We shall begin to have Made in Nigeria television, Made in Nigeria refrigerators, Made in Nigeria phones that will be used. And these industries will create jobs for all of you, the youth of Nigeria. Great Nigerian youth.
Great.
As your leaders, we stand here as a bond and as a token between you and the government. We are that bridge. If this government fails, hold us responsible. We have firm confidence
that the government under President Bola Ahmed Tinubu and distinguished Senator Ahmed Shettima, with the Secretary to the Governor of the Federation, Senator Akumi, is marching forward. The government will do everything in its powers to ensure that your efforts shall not be in vain. In line with the solemn words of our national anthem, that the labors of our heroes' path shall never be in vain. Great Nigerian youth, great Nigerian youth, I want to assure you that you are the heroes present, and this government shall ensure that your labors shall not be in vain. A new era is here. A new Nigeria is here. We will be greater than Dubai. We will be greater than Singapore. We will be greater than this country. They move from third world to the first world. Nigeria, it is our time to move forward. Our hopes have been dashed in times past. But I urge you all, let us rise with renewed hope. It is a new dawn for our country, a new dawn for Nigeria. Thank you, and God bless.